Hey there, friends! I have lost 130 pounds and kept it off for 7 years. In this video, I'm going to share with you exactly how I went from my heaviest weight of 275 pounds to 145 pounds, my current and lowest weight. I'm going to tell you exactly how long it took me, what I did, and some of the setbacks I had. My weight my entire life. In my teenage years and my early 20s, I tried losing weight with fad diets. They worked really well. I lost the weight very quickly, but they weren't sustainable because I had to take things away in order to lose weight. So it led to me gaining back all the weight that I lost until I hit my heaviest weight, 275, and I was in my late 20s. I started to get sleep apnea. I had plantar fasciitis so bad I could barely walk, and my health problems were getting really bad every day. So I knew I had to do something to change. I decided to do small changes and use portion control because I thought it was a way of eating what I liked, but getting in a calorie deficit so I could actually lose the weight and keep it off. By doing that, I was able to lose 50 pounds in 3 months. So I started with small changes. I swapped out the calorie drinks like regular pop for diet pop. Then I started eating, instead of a bag of chips a night for a snack, I started to have a bowl. And then I started looking at the backs of packages and measuring out my food according to the serving sizes on the packages. I started to get results because I was eating what I liked. I wasn't taking it away, but I was eating less of it. And then I couldn't really do much physically. I was so heavy, I couldn't really bend down to tie my shoes. I couldn't go up and down the stairs without being out of breath. So I decided the easiest thing for me to do physically was walk. I couldn't do it for very long, so I just made a pact with my husband, who was also at his heaviest weight of 375 pounds. He had just been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. We decided to get out and move our body every single day. We started with 5 to 15 minutes and combined it with the portion control. We had to stop every few minutes because we were getting leg cramps, my foot was sore, we were out of breath, and we just kept moving as much as we could every single day until the portion control combined with moving our bodies and making small changes like drinking diet pop instead of regular, we lost 50 pounds really quickly because we had so much weight to lose. And we were able to stick to the portion control. Then, after our first 50 pounds, the weight did slow down a little bit coming off. It slowed down to a really good amount if you want to lose it slow and steady to keep it off, 1 to 2 pounds a week. At that point, Kyle started to reverse his type 2 diabetes because he was doing it with diet and exercise. I got medically cleared of using a sleep apnea machine, and my plantar fasciitis started to feel a little better. So we were able to increase the amount of time that we were walking. We went from 5 to 15 minutes to 30 to 45 minutes a day, and we continued with the portion control. That, for the next 7 months, allowed us to lose the next 50 pounds. So we lost 100 pounds in a year. By using portion control, small changes, and walking every single day. After losing 100 pounds, our weight loss really did start to slow down, and we made the decision to get married, and we thought that we could speed up. We had about 30 pounds each left to lose, and we thought, hey, let's try to speed this up.
And I think, like, we get a lot of those questions from the friends about either their wedding coming up or someone else's wedding is in the near future, and how do we, or how do I get in shape and lose weight really fast in order to hit that date? And funny enough, that was our first setback. We were really excited. We set a wedding date. We had lost the 100 pound milestone already past that. And that was actually the first roadblock for us.
Yeah, that was when the panic set in and we were like, how do we get this weight off very fast? let's take away treats, let's take away some of the food groups. So we lowered the carbs that we were eating and we took away all the treats. We had been eating low calorie ice cream, low calorie versions of all our favorite things.
Low calorie fries, cookies. And I think the pressure is what really, really set us back.
Yes.
To get that last 30 or 40 pounds off.
Yeah, it did. So when we took it all away, you know, it did work a little bit, but by the time we got everything for our wedding, we were having a candy bar. Because I had taken away all the treats, I started sneaking the chocolate bars that we bought for a candy bar at the wedding when Kyle wasn't looking, and at night when he was sleeping, I'd be eating the chocolate. And so what happened was we got a little bit in better shape for our wedding, but after the wedding, I gained 10 pounds that I had lost, and it was starting to come back on very quickly because I couldn't stop eating. All the treats that I had taken away, I was trying to like almost make up for it, and all that pressure, like Kyle said, he gained 10 pounds back as well.
So I didn't partake in any treats until our wedding, but after is when I started gaining weight. But the couple weeks or months leading up to the wedding, I may not have, you know, had any treats or snuck anything, but pretty much every waking moment I was obsessed with thoughts and thinking about treats, ice cream, pizza, whatever, and it was miserable.
The other thing that you were doing at that time was when we were measuring out our peanut butter, Kyle's scoop of peanut butter for a tablespoon would get a little bit higher every single day. It would be a heaping tablespoon. So where he might not have been sneaking treats, he was adding but not counting it in like the portions that we were eating.
Getting a little lackadaisical with my measuring.
Yeah, and that happened because of the pressure and the taking everything away. So once we started gaining the 10 pounds, we were both really scared of getting our health issues back. So we decided, okay, we gotta put the treats back in, go back to portion control, and this is where we did just a little bit to help the weight continue to come off steady, but not deny ourselves. We added the treats back in, but we upped our cardio. It was 20 to 45 minutes, 7 days a week, and then we added some weight training 4 to 5 times a week. That was to build some muscle to fill out the loose skin that we did have, and it also helped us like sort of recomp our bodies. We continued to lose. We lost the 10 pounds that we had gained, and 1 to 2 pounds a week, we eventually lost the 30 other pounds that we had to lose. So in total, it took us 2 years, because after the first year of losing 100 pounds, it did take us, like I said, a year to get back on track, figure out trial and error, add the treats back in, and realize, hey, it's slow and steady wins the race. Rushing is causing us to fail. So we realize we got to look at it like a lifestyle change, not a diet. This is not anyone else's journey but your own. So if you're somebody who's like, oh, I got to lose weight quick for an event, like we said, the pressure, the taking away way too much too quick, you might get results. But will it stay off is the question.
And like willpower, we've found only lasts for a very, very short amount of time. It's to always be fighting it or trying to have willpower to say no to everything is not, for us, a fun way to live.
And that was why that last year of weight loss was a bit rocky. If we go back and we look now, we're like, this is why we started the channel, to share with people. You can lose it and love what you're doing, but you can lose it on your own time. You don't have to make a rush time frame. And the reason why we did lose the weight and keep it off is because we don't deny ourselves. We do enjoy a balanced diet every day. In portion, we did for years. We've started counting calories the last year or so because we were ready for it. In the beginning, we weren't ready to count calories because we had emotional eating underneath. So we did the portion control. That way we could go in a deficit without all the numbers affecting our head.
So when we get asked questions like, what do you guys do if you have an important date coming up where you have to lose weight for it? Our answer is we don't do that anymore because it never worked for us.
No, if you just aim to be consistent, like your food and eat a little bit less, that was what worked the best for us. And Now, to keep the weight off and just to get a little bit leaner, show the muscle that we have, I eat about 1900 to 2000 calories a day, and Kyle eats about 25, would you say? And we do an hour to an hour and 20 minutes of cardio 6 days a week.
2500, not 25.
Oh, sorry, 2500 calories he eats. And yeah, we built that up over time where we were okay to do more cardio and okay to count calories. It was slow and steady wins the race. So hopefully that helps you guys. One step at a time, that's what we always say. Love what you're doing. If you don't love it, it's gonna make it really hard to sustain it.
And coming up on the new year, a lot of people are gonna try some crazy stuff.
Yes, that's why we're doing this video, because we want you to know, lifestyle change, not diet.
It didn't take you like, you know, a month to put on the weight. So it might, we're not saying it's not possible, but it might take you a little bit of time.
And it's okay. It's your journey, so it takes whatever it takes. Don't worry about what anyone else is doing. Do what works for you and take the time that you need to take. If you want to know exactly what we ate to lose our first and next 50 pounds, we do have 2 weight loss guides down below. Exact meal plans, portions, family-friendly recipes, links are down there. We also have a brand new guilt-free cookbook, low-calorie versions of all your favorite food without the guilt and extra calories. And you can watch these 2 videos for free if you like. We also, the supplements that we use, the link is down there for that as well. Harder than last time supplements. Love you. Be gentle on yourself.
Whoa.
Love what you're eating and do it up, buttercup. Kick hard weight loss in the bean. That's a bean, PG for YouTube. Shake it till your mama made it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We love you. Good luck on your journey. We're here for you. Bye.
See you guys.
Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.